You know, a lot of workplace so-called experts tell targets all the time it's their personal responsibility to stop their bullying. Well, a couple problems with that. They did not invite it. They don't deserve the bullying, okay? But I'm sick and tired of hearing all this advice, which WBI does not endorse. For our endorsement of what we say people should do, go to the website and read. But for right now, this short clip is to summarize our latest 2012 survey. We conducted an online survey that you may have participated in. 1,598 people who are all very familiar with bullying participated. They either are currently bullied, or they were bullied, just not now, or they've witnessed it but never been personally bullied. The cockamamie advice that people often advise are, you have to confront the bully. So in this survey, we asked how many people confronted the bully and was it effective? Well, here is the stunning fact. In only 3% of the cases, 3.6% technically of the cases, did confronting work. You realize that's a fail rate of 96.4%. Then people say, well, tell the bully's boss. Go tell the bully's boss what the bully's doing. You think the bully's boss doesn't know what the bully's doing? Half the time, we estimate, the bully's boss assigned the bully to do to you what happened to you. But anyway, back to the survey. How effective was it? In how many cases did that stop the bullying? 3.3% of the cases. So often you're told to go to the senior manager too. Go up to the executive and tell the executive. And we actually do advise that, but we tell you how to do that specifically and don't whine or complain about the bullying, but to make a fiscal argument. Here's the point. In the survey, only 3.7% of the people said this was an effective tactic. And you know why? It's because the bully has positioned him or herself over the years with ingratiation so that if and when they're exposed, they're never going to be held accountable. The boss, the executive, the owner, the senior manager tells you, the target, you're the problem for bringing them the bad news. And finally, we asked about HR. How's HR doing? Did HR, by complaining to HR and filing a complaint, did that result in stopping the bullying? Yes, it did in 4.7% of the cases. So there you have it. 95% of the time, no, but 4.7% of the time, yes. And I would say that that would probably include the cases in which illegal harassment is involved. We also asked in this new survey whether or not a person filed a lawsuit, went to a government agency and filed a formal complaint, or found an attorney. Now, the effectiveness of an attorney and government agency and lawsuits are all in double digits, ranging from 11 to 16%. But here's why. Because in 1 in 5 bullying cases, illegal harassment's a part of it. But when there's no illegality, an attorney, a government anti-discrimination agency, and a lawsuit will not work for you. Those are failure rates. But anyway, they're double digit in effectiveness. Unions were effective about 9% of the time, but very few people had unions. Compare this dismal, hovering around 3% effectiveness rate with the baseline. And for us, the baseline is we asked, did you do nothing? Did you just as a bully target hope that time passing alone would end your misery? And that was effective in only 3.3% of the cases. So there you have it. Confronting, telling the bully's boss, senior management, HR is just barely more effective or equally as ineffective as doing nothing. So long story short, bully targets cannot stop the bullying. They didn't cause it, and they most certainly can't stop it. Only an employer can stop the bullying.